That's the point. You're probably not going to pay your bills on time, which means they get to charge you interest and they get to make more money off of you. If the credit card companies can hook you in college, they probably have you hooked for life.
Now, I don't think they're really trying to issue these four-year-olds credit cards, but they're teaching them so when they get to the college campus, they pick Visa instead of picking Discover or instead of picking MasterCard. It's a brand war, just like Papa John's and Domino's and Pizza Hut. It's a brand war, or Pepsi and Coke. It's a brand war, right? And they're fighting for that market share tooth and nail, and they're spending big bucks to do it, and they're starting to train children. It's called kiddie branding. We found this one. Is Barbie. Cool shopping Barbie. Now, I had girls at my house, and so we're not mad at Barbie. We have Barbie and Barbie parts all over our house. We kind of like Barbie. We wish she'd eat a little better, but we kind of like Barbie. You know? So. But I had a real problem with Cool Shopping Barbie, because Cool Shopping Barbie came out with a little MasterCard taped to her hand, and of course included in the kit is a full-size MasterCard. This particular product by Mattel was sponsored by MasterCard. So what's the message here? If you're 5 years old, and you're playing with Barbies, and you want to be pretty and cool when you're shopping, and you're cool, what do? You don't use Discover. You don't use American Express. You use MasterCard. That's what cool people do. That's the message, isn't it? And it's drilled home and drilled home and drilled home and drilled home. By the way, this little thing came with no cash. And here's what's sickening. Here's what we're training our four-year-olds. Listen, this is how you know you're cool right here. Listen. Credit approved, you airhead. Sad thing is, this is having an effect on our youngsters. Junior Achievement did a study called The Case for Economic Education and discovered two things. More young adults filed bankruptcy than graduated from college last year. And colleges are telling them in this same study over and over and over that they're losing more students to credit card debt problems than they are to academic failure. You get your credit cards up, you gotta go get a job and pay them. You quit school and come home, which by the way activates your student loans 6 months later, and you don't have an education to get the better job to be able to pay the student loans. There's a cycle here that's really got socioeconomic impact. It's a real problem. We, the consumer, have to wake up and say, you know, I'm thinking maybe no. There's an idea. Just something to think about.
I feel like in college it's such this mindset of, oh, I'll just accumulate student loans. I'll just accumulate credit cards. I won't worry about all the choices I'm making right now. You know, this is college. This is the best years of my life. And I'll worry about all that when I graduate and when I go get, you know, a high-paying job. That's when I'll worry about it. And that's such a mindset that's there today. That's something that I kind of fell into. When every decision you make, you know, follows you.
College. And part of it is that you'll have older friends and adults will say, do it while you can, do it while you can. So there's all these do it while you can moments where you go, I've got to go to Europe right now. I don't have the money, I don't have anything saved up, but when I'm in my 30s, Europe will be closed. I'll only be able to vacation in Chattanooga or Branson, Missouri. The only way to really find yourself is with a backpack and a Eurorail pass and be in Paris and eat some bad bread. And I thought, this is...